Hi students, welcome to ALPO's e-learning chemistry classes for first year. The running chapter is stoichiometry and now we are in session number 35. In previous session, we discussed about the concentration terms. There, after completing the physical methods to express the concentration, in last session, we discussed about the chemical method to express the concentration, that is nothing but molarity. Different formulae to calculate molarity, and then what are the laws that are related to molarity, all these we discussed in previous session. And now in this session we are going to learn one more method which is frequently we are using for titrations. Frequently, actually, even though the convenient method to express the concentration is no doubt at all molarity, but to find out the exact values in titrations, most of the cases where the balancing equation, without balancing the equation, if we want to solve the titration numericals, then we have to go for the normality. That is, that normality is one more chemical method to express the concentration. And in this session, we are going to learn on this normality. And if we recall molarity, what is molarity? Molarity M is nothing but number of moles of solute by volume of solution in liters. Simply, it is nothing but moles per liter. The same type of concentration term, but the difference is here. Normality is nothing but number of gram equivalent weights, GEW, is gram equivalent weight. Number of gram equivalent weights of solute by volume of solution in liters, that is nothing but gram equivalent weights per liter. This is normality. And now the biggest question is, we know mole, but what is gram equivalent weight? And for that purpose, first of all, we should be able to calculate the equivalent weight. Let me give the comparison, thereby you can easily understand what is equivalent weight and gram equivalent weight. In case of moles, you know gram molecular weight. Once you know the gram molecular weight, now number of moles, how you are measuring? Number of moles is nothing but weight of solute by gram molecular weight. This is known as number of moles. Clear? And now gram equivalent weight, if you know, then number of gram equivalent weights, instead of moles we are using number of gram equivalent weights. This is nothing but weight of solute by gram equivalent weight. This can also be considered, number of moles is nothing but number of gram molecular weights present in the solution. Number of moles, just you know, number of moles is nothing but number of gram molecular weights. So that particular number of gram molecular weights is, we are having other word, that is nothing but mole. That's why number of gram molecular weights we are considering as number of moles. But whereas, in case of number of gram equivalent weights, there is no other term like mole. That's why directly we are using this term. And if you are observing, if you feel that number of moles is nothing but number of gram molecular weights, these are same. Both these two words are same. The only difference is, in case of gram molecular weight, these can also be considered as mole. Whereas in this case, that number of gram equivalent weights is having or is finding no other term. That is the only difference. The similarity, that's why I am giving. And now the question is, we know gram molecular weight. How? Just it is nothing but the sum of all atomic weights is gram molecular weight. All gram atomic weights is gram molecular weight. But how to know this gram equivalent weight? What is that gram equivalent weight? Is it not? By definition, actually, in coming sessions, we are having thorough discussion on these equivalent weights. Equivalent weight, how to measure that equivalent weight for different compounds. All these we are having a separate session for that one. Okay, there we can discuss them in elaborated conditions. Clear? And different possible conditions, how to understand to the concept to measure the equivalent weights, all these we will discuss in coming sessions, no doubt at all. But here, for your convenient purpose, first let me define gram equivalent weight or equivalent weight. Gram equivalent weight is similarly, gram molecular weight simply we are considering as molecular weight. In a similar way, gram equivalent weight is also considered as equivalent weight. Actually, equivalent weight is nothing but, by definition, here I am not writing on the board, just I am giving orally, and in equivalent weight sessions I will explain thoroughly again by writing on the board. Just you remember, equivalent weight is nothing but the weight of any substance that can react or that can react or that can replace 1.008 grams of hydrogen or 8 grams of oxygen or 35.5 grams of chlorine. The amount of any substance that can react or replace 1.008 grams of hydrogen or 8 grams of oxygen or 35.5 grams of chlorine is known as its equivalent weight. Are you clear with this definition? The amount of any substance that can react or that can replace this much of hydrogen, this much of oxygen or this much of chlorine is known as its equivalent weight. And you remember, in chemical reactions what we are considering is, we never observe one mole of any substance to react with one mole of other substance always. It is not possible always. Say for example, NaOH, when it is reacting with HCl, no doubt at all, one mole of NaOH react with one mole of HCl giving NaCl plus H2O. Sometimes it may happen. But in case, if NaOH is reacting with H2SO4, just you observe, this H2SO4 requires 2 moles of NaOH to give Na2SO4 plus H2O, 2H2O. And in case, if this NaOH is reacting with H3PO4, that is nothing but phosphoric acid, then it requires 3 moles of NaOH. Like that, we can't find the exact mole-mole relation when they are reacting among themselves, even in acid-base titrations. But you remember, forever in any reaction, 1 gram equivalent weight of a substance can always react only with 1 gram equivalent weight of the other substance. In a reaction, 1 gram equivalent weight of X is able to react with 1 gram equivalent weight of Y, but not one mole. Sometimes it may happen, 1 mole of X may react with 1 mole of Y, but it is not true in all cases. But in case of gram equivalent weights, it is always true that in any chemical reaction, if you observe among different reactants, then one of the reactant 1 gram equivalent weight can always react with 1 gram equivalent weight of the other reactant. That is the condition. That's why normality is of having its own priority in expressing the concentration terms. Clear? And now, with all these one, the question is, again, we are not having the solution for our doubt. That is nothing but, what is gram equivalent weight?
What is gram equivalent weight? It is explained. Gram equivalent weight is nothing but the weight of any substance that can react or replace 1.008 grams of hydrogen or 8 grams of oxygen or 35.5 grams of chlorine. Is it not? And now, okay, by definition we know gram equivalent weight. The weight that can replace or react with 1.008 grams of hydrogen or 8 grams of oxygen or 35.5 grams of chlorine. But how to measure this gram equivalent weight? How to measure this gram equivalent weight? Just you remember, here this formula is number of gram equivalent weights, because so many students are confused in getting gram equivalent weight is different from number of gram equivalent weights. Say for example, one compound is having gram equivalent weight 10. Gram equivalent weight is 10, for example. Now, how many gram equivalent weights present in 100 grams of that substance, if they ask, or in 80 grams of that substance? Gram equivalent weight is given, and now they are asking for number of gram equivalents. Then what we have to do? Weight of substance is 80, by gram equivalent weight is given as 10. It is 8. I think now you got the idea. Number of gram equivalent weights are nothing but number of gram equivalent weights present in the given weight. Gram equivalent weight we have to consider. That is how to, by definition we know now, but to measure this, what to do is, just you remember, this gram equivalent weight is, with the general formula we can write like this. It is gram molecular weight by Z factor. Again, I am repeating, gram equivalent weight is nothing but gram molecular weight of the substance by Z factor. Or in case if the substance is an element, we can consider gram atomic weight by valency. Gram atomic weight by valency. Actually, in some cases, gram atomic weight by Z, like that they are giving. Here, we need not give that Z value in case of atomic weights, because that atomic weights Z value is found to be only in terms of valency, no other terms. But in case of other molecules, that Z may be valency, that Z may be basicity, that Z may be acidity, that Z may be change in oxidation state, like that. So that means this Z is nothing but, depending on the nature of the substance, we are considering different factors for Z. In case of molecules, we are considering, that is elements, we are considering the valency of the molecule. And in case of acid, basicity, I think you know from your lower classes, basicity is nothing but the number of replaceable hydrogens, that is H plus ions, is known as basicity. Well, best known example, let me give here, it is H2SO4. How many hydrogens can be replaceable? 2. So Z is 2. In case of HCl, the replaceable hydrogen is 1. So Z is 1. Like that, the number of replaceable hydrogens in acid is known as basicity. And that Z is nothing but, in case of acids, that Z is nothing but basicity. And now, acidity. Number of replaceable OH groups that are present in the given base is nothing but the acidity. Acidity is nothing but number of replaceable OH groups. Number of replaceable hydrogens, H plus, is nothing but basicity. And whereas number of replaceable OH minus groups is nothing but acidity. Clear? And now change in oxidation state. Change in oxidation, already we know what is oxidation state. In any chemical reaction, when a compound X is changing from one oxidation state to the other oxidation state, how much of the oxidation state is changed? Either it may be increased or decreased. The change may be increased or decreased, irrespective of that. how many units of that change is happening. That is considered as Z. Clear? And now, with that one, just in this case, just we should know the Z factor only in terms of base city and S city, that is sufficient for this class, because we are having a thorough discussion on this equivalent weights in the coming sessions. There we can go for elaboration. Clear? And here, just you remember, one more factor is there to count this gram equivalent weight. It is nothing but N factor, you remember. Z factor or N factor you can use. And here, only with one statement I will conclude this part. Just you remember, Z factor is nothing but imaginary. Z factor is imaginary. That means, by observing the molecule, we can say how many hydrogens are replaced. By observing the reaction, by observing the molecule, not the reaction, by observing the molecule, what is the basicity or what is the acidity or what is the oxidation state change possible, all these we are imaginarily we can measure. That is Z factor. But N is reality, not imaginary. For your understanding purpose, let me give an excellent example. Every weekend exam you are writing and you are getting some marks. Say for example, you are constantly maintaining 600 like that. Then automatically from internal assessment, we are guessing that definitely in the final examination, your marks may be 600 like that. That is imaginary, that is Z factor. Why? Because you having final examination, how many marks you are getting, we don't know. Because it is possible only when you attempt the exam and you got the marks. But imaginarily from internal assessment, by observing your weekend exam marks, we are guessing. That is Z factor. Now, N factor. Finally, that person, that X person or you yourself, you wrote the exam. And if you are getting marks only 500 around, then that is N factor. So Z factor is imaginary, but after writing the exam, what exactly you are getting, that is N factor. Here also, H2SO4, by observing the molecule, Z factor is assumed to be 2. But in chemical reaction, both these two hydrogens may be replaced, or only one hydrogen may be replaced. So it can be observed only when the reaction is happening. Before the reaction, it is not possible. Before the reaction, only by observing the molecule, we can have an assumption. That assumption factor is Z factor. And when it is involved in the chemical reaction, what is really happening in that chemical reaction, if we observe how many hydrogens are replaced in that one really, if there also, if two hydrogens are replaced, we can say that N factor is 2. In such a case, Z factor and N factor, these two are same. That is what we assumed, the same thing happened there. But unlike that, in case it's assumed Z factor is 2, but when it is involved in the chemical reaction, if only one hydrogen is replaced, then even though Z factor is 2, its N factor is 1 only. So just you remember, with all these, you remember, my dear students, when the individual compounds are given, when individual compounds are given, just you have to use the Z factor. That is nothing but imagination. But when the reaction is given involving that compound, a compound when involved in a reaction, that reaction is given, then you have to go for that N factor. That is nothing but the real factor. Are you clear with this one? So like that, by considering the Z factor or N factor, you have to calculate gram equivalent weight just by using this formula. Gram molecular weight by Z. Say for example, NaOH. What is Z value for NaOH? Only one OH present, hence Z is 1. And for H2SO4, Z is 2. In such a case, in NaOH, the equivalent weight is nothing but molecular weight by 1. And in H2SO4, the equivalent weight is nothing but molecular weight by 2. Like that, simply by considering the Z factor, we can measure the equivalent weight.
that gram equivalent weight, which is measured as a gram molecular weight by Z factor, is used to measure the number of gram equivalent weights as the weight of the solute by gram equivalent weight will provide the number of gram equivalent weights. Such number of gram equivalent weights present in 1 liter of solution is known as normality. I think you got some idea about this. And in the coming session, I will conclude this normality and one more, it is nothing but molarity and formality, generalizations we are having. All these we have to discuss. In the coming session, I will conclude that one. Okay, you be clear with these facts. What is Z, how to, what is equivalent weight, what is Z, what is N. Just I gave the introduction. So much we have to discuss in the coming sessions. Okay.